Assalamu alaikum, I'm Asadul Adel from AIFL. Today I'm going to show you how can we measure the distance using a single camera through detecting a face. All the explanation of code will be available on this video. All the information you need, the blog post will be available on the description below. I will put the slides which I'm going to explain the mathematics. And the majority of mathematics, I will suggest a video which will be available on the my YouTube description, so you can watch that as well. But I'm going to explain the a few things of mathematics, the concept behind that as well. And so let's get into it. So calculating the distance using single camera. This diagram shows how things work. Here is the CMOS sensor or the image plane. It is the real plane. On the real plane, the object will remain same, or you can say that it is the real world. On the CMOS sensor side, there is the sensor where the object or anything image will be appeared on. So it is the simply the lens. The distance between lens and CMOS is the focal length. CMOS sensor, is the focal length. So you can say that a height of object on the CMOS sensor is the A, you can consider here, and the height of object on the object plane, you can say that is H, and the distance is equal to D, and the theta is angle, theta 1 is the angle. So here you can say that A divided by focal length is equal to 10 theta 1 height of object on the object plane divided by the distance on the object plane from lens to the object actually. Now here is the another picture which shows that the object has moved from its initial position to the final position, which is just changed in the distance, so it comes closer to the camera, so that the theta has changed, means the angle between the these will be changed as well. So the focal length remains same, but the height of object on the CMOS sensor will be changed as well. As object comes closer to the CMOS the camera, the height of object increases on the CMOS sensor. So the height will become B. Initially the height was A, now it becomes B. And the on the image plane, on the object plane, height remains H because it does not changes. The distance changes, so the distance becomes D minus M. So here is the equation. B divided by F, 10 theta 2 equal to H divided by D minus M. So the distance, because of that, we subtract the M from the D, so that distance becomes that. Now here is the equations. These are being divided. And all the equations will be explained on the another video. I will link that in the description below because he provides lots of information. So that will be best for you in case you want to take dive into this method. So the final equation I'm going to show you here is this T equal to M1 minus A divided by B. So this is the final equation. Now the actual implementation of this is a bit different because it's for a static image. We are going to use for a real-time detection, so there will be a slight difference. So we're gonna go into this. So let's get into the code. So I have already opened up CMD here, and actually it's in project distance measurement directory. So first let's open the code here. Nothing here, just there is hardcascade file and reference image. So reference image, I'm gonna show you here is my reference image. I have just captured the image and measured the distance from my camera to the my face. So now you can see here that I'm using a Ruben to measure the distance from my face to camera. So that's really straightforward. I have already created a script for that you can capture the
refresh me. So here is the script. That's really simple. I'm just detecting phase in my distance. And in case you want to know how can you capture, just press C on your camera and it will show you that it's capturing. So that's really straightforward thing else. So we will just move to the distance measurement. So we have to create a simple file. Distance.py. Really simple and straightforward. Now here is the code which simply takes the frame from camera and shows on the screen. So simply we are here, we are just defining camera object. The frames actually runs in finite loops. Actually video is simply the frames running and the infinite loop are loop. So we are just defining while loop. While the frames are available, our cameras window will be shown as simply the frame will be shown on the screen unless there is a frame. Either we can break this loop by using this CV2 wait key function, which checks if any keys are pressed on the board or not. So E code is checking that as well. It just wait key simply waits for time, and then in case we press alt key, old key just sends the key from the keyboard. So we are just pressing, when we press Q, because we have a string argument that is a Q, so it will break the loop. And in the end, we are just releasing the camera, which we initialized first is the camera object now. Then we are just destroying the windows. So let's run the code. Now here is the frames coming directly from the camera. It's running in the loop. Here I'm just using my smartphone camera for the video, because my laptop camera is not that good. So I want to show you that as well. So in case I've just changed the argument here to zero. So let's see how it. Now here I'm again using this system by. So here is my laptop's camera. That's not that good. You can see the here, and I'm also going to open up VariantBack here. You can see the difference of quality here in that camera. It's coming from my cell phone. Here is the cell phone. Now you can see here. I'm just using hand showing to the. And my smartphone camera. So my smartphone camera is way more better than this my laptop camera. So I'm using that as well. So in case your laptop camera is not that good, you can watch my video. I have already created how can you use this RMK webcam. It's really simple. Just you have to download this. But in case you have not figured out how, then you can watch my video as well. So let's go further into it. So just I'm going to create a function. So here I've just defined a function which can detect the face using HaarCascade. So here I just defining an object, a classifier which can detect the face in the frame. So here is the function face data. Simply it will return the face width in the image, or you can say the frame in the frame. So first of all, we are just converting the image into gray, or BGR image into gray, and then we are just detecting the face, finding the face and assigning the values to this function. Here is the some parameter required, some like multi detect multi scale. It requires some image, and there are some parameters. It is the parameter of scaling, means how much you scale up or scale down the image in order to detect face. When the image is a bit larger, then you get find face more accurately or more accurately simply, but the processing power will be increased as well. So the frame rate may reduce in case your machine is not that much powerful. And this is the nearest neighbor. It affects when and it finds the face which is nearest it, something like that. So I can't figure out what is this, but nearest, it is the nearest neighbor, means how close it is to be faced. So this is parameter also fits. And here we are just iterating our through the faces. So in case there are multiple faces found, it will just extract the x, y, h and width. Simply it will extract x, y, means the rectangular value of the x face. It will just extract the ROI faces as we are the face is present. So it will be the x, y and width, height and width. So we are just drawing the rectangle around the ROIF faces. So it is simply the x and y location, and we are just starting from the x to plus c, adding the width of the face to reach the final position of the face. And then we are just using first coordinate of the y, and then we are just adding the height to it too, so that we can reach the maximum position of ROI of height in case. And then we are just passing the color. Here I have just assigned the tuple which contains three integer values, and this is the scaling factor, means how thick we are assigned line we need. So another, this we are just assigning w, means width of face to face width, and then we are returning it back. So here I'm going to run this code. Here I'm just calling this function and storing the width to the face width in the frame. So face data, and we are just passing the image to it, image in whatever case it is a frame. So let's run this code. Let's run this code again. So here you can see this bit clear image. Now you can see the face has been detected, a rectangle around this face been drawn. So another thing we have to do, simply have to create two functions. First function will simply find the focal length of the image. In case I have shown you the presentation as well, so I have to open up the presentation that you can see the. So I'm saying about this focal length. You can see this is the focal length, means from a lens to camera, the object, the focal length. So it will be remain constant unless it will not change much. But we have to find. How can we find this? Simply we will use the reference image in this condition as well, and then we will measure the distance using another function. I will create both of these functions and code it back, and then I will return back to you. Oh, here is the code. Let's run this code again. So I have run this several time. I found some issue that I'm running again. So now it's fine. So distance.py. So here you can see the face has been detected in frame as well as in the reference image. This is the rectangle drawn here. Here you can see this is the focal length has been found. So we're gonna use this focal length to measure the distance. So we're just going to close this window. I don't know why this is freezes, but the code is here. Here you can see this is the now these two functions I have created. One is for focal length finding. So for that, we need a distance. Measure distance means known distance. It will be known distance. So I just write it no, but I will correct this as well. Now here this is this code. We are using this known distance here in the focal length finder. Simply we are calling this as the measure distance. It is the known distance, which is 30 centimeter away from the face to camera. That is the distance, and it is the width of face in centimeters as well. Here I'm just defining colors, which I may be already explained. And here, yes, we are in distance, measure distance using find focal length, and real width means the real world width, and the width in the reference image. So the focal length will be equal to real width, width in the reference image multiplied by the measure distance. So it will be this known width, known distance, and the real width, which will be the known width here in our case, known width. So divided by known means known width or real width. It will return the focal length simply as that. And distance finder, it actually requires the focal length and real width, which is the known width, and the face width in the frame. Actually, we are using a distance finder to in the frame, so we are saying that face width in the frame. Now, distance actually is equal to real width, face width multiplied by the face focal length. So focal length here we find the focal length. We will use this focal length in here, and we will just divide the whole focal length multiplied by the real width to the actual the frame width in the frame. So we will return the distance here. So I have just here I have just read the image from the directory. Here it is the reference image. Now and then I am just calling this function to detect face and return back. It actually this function returns the width, so we are using this width to find the focal length. So here is the focal length, known distance, we know that, and known width, and the reference image width. So reference image width is this image width. Actually you can see this image width actually will be from this to this, it will be found in the found faces. Now let's move ahead. Now let's run this code. So here you can see the face has been detected and distance has been estimated. It's around 26-27 because the pointy box now is stable, so it will change accordingly, but it's estimates bit very accurately. It's not that errors difference or accuracy difference. So you fairly accurate. Now, another thing, I have to explain the code, then I will show you the how much it can face detector can detect and how much of it can show you the face distance estimation as well. So it's totally depend upon the face detector or any object detector which detects the object, so that you can estimate or find the distance. But actually this face detector works pretty well. Now here is the code. You can see this is simply when I actually I showed you that we have found the width of in the frame. So we are just checking if width is equal to zero, then do not find the distance, because when there is zero, we will find the issue of we will fall into the issue of a zero division. We don't want that. So we are just saying that if focal length or something like that, width of frame is equal to zero, you do not have to find the distance. Simple as that. Another thing, we are just finding the distance and storing to distance variable. Then here I'm just showing it on the screen. I just simply drawing the text on the screen. Here I've just created f string and it's distance in the distance variable here. So it is the position and the font and the scale level, how much it, the font's bigger should be, and the white is the color, and this is the thickness of the text. So we can increase up to, sorry, it's, I think I have to increase to 1, so you can see this is a bit larger text. So I have to open up CMD here. So here you can see the distance has become larger in size. So I have to show you that how far it can go.
So first thing, we're gonna use this distance estimation into the robot. Another thing, you can use this into any programmable tool, because you can process all the image processing on your computer and connect through Wi-Fi to a programmable drone. Because I can't afford that drone, so I'm not going to use this. But we're gonna use this into chassis robot. Since face detection is not that stable, we can change it into the QR code detection, because QR code is fairly stable than face detection, because the face detection bounding box is not that stable. Another thing, you have any concern or command, leave them down below, and I will put all the mention thing in the description below that you can access that. I will provide you code as well. So thank you so much for watching. Allah Hafiz.